Hello everyone, welcome back to I Say Kids. Today we are going to discuss about the Red Data Book. Before we proceed any further, I would request you not to subscribe to my channel. Of course, I'll be very happy if you do that, but I have another important request to make, that is to understand the sensitivity of the topic that we are going to discuss today. Also, please know that you do make a difference, big or small, whatever bit you do, it does matter. Let's try and make our difference a positive one. Now, what is Red Data Book? Red Data Book is a public document that is created for recording endangered and rare species of plants, animals, fungi, as well as some local subspecies that are present in a particular region. It is based on the research conducted between 1961 and 1964 by some Russian biologists. It is therefore sometimes referred to as Russian Red Data Book. Currently, it is being maintained by IUCN, which is International Union for Conservation of Nature. The main purpose of this book is to identify and protect those species which are on the verge of extinction. Please remember that extinction is forever. It cannot be reverted. Red Data Book contains color-coded information sheets, which are arranged according to the extinction risk of many species and subspecies. The color codes are as follows. Black is for the species that are confirmed to be extinct. Red for the species that are endangered. Amber is for species whose status is considered to be vulnerable. The color white represents those species which are rare. Green means species that were formerly endangered but their numbers have started to recover. Gray is for species that are vulnerable, endangered or rare, but unfortunately we don't have sufficient information or data to classify them properly. The IUCN Red List is a critical indicator of the health of the world's biodiversity. Biodiversity is all the different kinds of life we'll find in one area. The variety of animals, plants, fungi, and even microorganisms like bacteria that make up our natural world. The Red List also tells us where we ought to be concerned, where the urgent needs are to do something to prevent the despoliation of this world. It is a great agenda for the work of conservationists. Now, what are extinct species? Species of plant or animal that are no more. That means there is no more individual of that species alive anywhere in the world. The species has died out. Splendid poison frog, which was endemic to Western Panama, and bramble K. melomis, which was endemic to the Great Barrier Reef in Australia, are some of the animals that have gone extinct very recently. See this beautiful bird out there. It is referred to as Shobuj Mayur, which means green peafowl. It was a native of Bangladesh, but it has not been seen since 1930. Extinct in the wild. Is species which is known only to survive in cultivation or in captivity or as a naturalized population well outside the past range. However, there is no free living natural population of the species. Scimitar oryx and socorro dove are the examples of species that are extinct in the wild. Critically endangered species. When the best available evidence indicates that it faces an extremely high risk of extinction in the wild. Adex, axolotl are examples of critically endangered species. Endangered means the species that faces an extremely high risk of extinction in the near future. Vulnerable is the species that faces a medium risk, medium term high risk of extinction, for example, dugong. Near threatened, the species that may be considered threatened in the near future, like African grey parrot and blue-billed duck. Least concern, that means there is no immediate threat to the survival of the species. For example, Indian peafowl. Look at this beautiful pigeon. It says, shoot us with cameras, not guns. Let us see some facts. Global figures for 2023 IUCN Red List of Threatened Species says that more than 100,000 species were assessed and more than 35,000 species are threatened with extinction currently. More than 900 species are now extinct. Around 80 are extinct in the wild. Around 7,000 are critically endangered, 13,000 endangered, 14,000 vulnerable, more than 7,000 are near threatened. Freshwater species. More than 25,000 freshwater species have been mapped as threatened. Almost a third of these are threatened with extinction, and over 200 are already extinct. We are losing freshwater species more rapidly than either marine or terrestrial species, but they are disappearing largely unnoticed. All of the world's freshwater dolphin species are now threatened with extinction. European bison, Europe's largest land animal, has moved from vulnerable to near threatened thanks to the continued conservation efforts. IUCN Red List of Threatened Species now includes assessments of the majority of dry forest trees in Madagascar, including updated assessments for 23 rosewood and Dalbergia tree species. These species are highly exploited for their precious wood, with over 90% of them now threatened. Rosewood species are used across the world in the timber trade and are one of the world's most illegally trafficked byproducts. Guam rail is a species of flightless bird endemic to the United States territory of Guam. It has recovered from the status of extinct in the wild to critically endangered after being kept in the captive breeding program for 35 long years. California condor, the largest North America land bird, was the first bird to recover before Guam rail. More than 5,000 trees from 180 countries have been added to the red list this year. The American elm enters the red list for the first time as endangered, a dominant woodland tree across Canada and the United States. This species has been declining for decades due to serious invasive fungal pathogen, Dutch elm disease. The number of assessed species of fungi has almost doubled, with 79 fungi added to the red list. At least 15 fungal species that grow in the semi-natural grasslands are threatened with extinction. The bright red splendid waxcap is one such vulnerable species, threatened by the use of nitrogen-based fertilizers and airborne nitrogen pollution. Other species whose conservation status has declined. Pancake tortoise, red-capped mangabey, European rabbit, Dakota skipper, and these beautiful flowers. Don't you think it is time to think and act wisely? Let's see what are the major causes for wildlife loss. The major reason is wildlife exploitation. Humans use plants and animals for so many aspects of daily life. In order to fulfill these needs, humans perform overfishing, poaching, hunting. Wildlife exploitation is responsible for 37% of the loss in wildlife biodiversity. Deforestation is another major cause. It's no wonder that habitat degradation and change have resulted in a 31% loss of wildlife. Related to this is complete habitat loss, which is responsible for 13% of wildlife loss. Next is pollution. I'm sure you want to be a part of solution, not a part of pollution. Waterways, groundwater sources, air are all polluted with runoff from manufacturing facilities, mining practices, and the fumes from the traffic and burning fossil fuels. Pesticides sprayed onto crops inadvertently kills other plant species. Garbage and littering fills the land with non-biodegradable plastics that can be consumed by animals both on land and in sea. All of these reasons and more explain why pollution is directly responsible for the loss of 4% of wildlife biodiversity. Global climate change has exterminated 7% of all wildlife. Invasive species. Now, what is invasive species? Animals must be thinking that the humans are an invasive species the way we treat them. Now, there is an increased mobility of humankind. We all know that. This has also allowed for the spread of non-native plants and animals to move into new areas. Non-native wildlife is referred to as invasive species, and they are responsible for the loss of 5% of all wildlife and for threatening 42% of all endangered species. Invasive species move into an area and quickly reproduce and spread. They outnumber native species, preying on them and competing with them for food resources. Diseases. disease among plants and animals is responsible for a 2% loss in biodiversity. Disease is a byproduct of the causes of wildlife loss mentioned before, because it occurs in unhealthy and unbalanced ecosystems. Although the diseases are naturally occurring, an unhealthy ecosystem cannot fend for itself in the same way a healthy ecosystem can. Be aware of your own impact. Let's see what can be done to improve the situation. Remember, ours is a finite earth. Let's be stewards of our environment. Educate people. People need to be educated and empowered to work at a local level to promote small-scale conservation efforts. Business owners need to be held accountable for the environmental degradation that their work may cause and further mandated to reduce and offset this destruction. Policymakers on an international level need to tackle wildlife trade and poaching concerns. National governments should focus on converting their nation to renewable energy sources. On an individual level, people need to focus on the 3 R's, which is reduce, reuse, and recycle. The problem can no longer be ignored. Action is necessary across boundaries and cultures, from the lowest levels of society to the highest. Action starts with us. Do your bit. Make a positive impact. We don't have another planet to go and live on. So, act now and prevent another extinction, another animal to go extinct, another plant to go into endangered mode. Anything that you can do, any way you can help restore or replenish the biodiversity. Thank you. Thank you so much for being with me. Have a good day.